All right, it's always a challenge when you try to rewire a trailer, especially if like this one's been sitting a while. And what happened, we got a mouse nest in here, and mice ain't nice to wires. So I got a bad ground, I got no signal, I got some light. So in instances like this, what you do is you go to Pep Boys. And what you want to do, you want to isolate your harness. So what I did, this is like the best way to do it, man, I'm telling you. You make sure your harness is plugged in, you route that through your tongue or however you want to do it. And then where you're going to splice off, you get one of these connectors and then you splice off again. Right? So now you're isolating the harness. So when like, you know, somebody rips the harness off the truck, you don't have to rewire the whole trailer. So that unplugs. Then you plug one of these in, you route this through the channel in the back, and then you take these and you split it. You can cut this right off and split them and replug it back in. So you buy two of these at Pep Boys, right? So then obviously the green is your, listen, make sure I'm talking this right before I make you all, yeah. So your green usually is your passenger signal, yellow is your driver. Brown is your tails and your markers, and yellow and white's your ground. And redundancy, redundancy, redundancy. But the point is that when you use these, you could buy these pre-length at Pep Boys or wherever you want to, you know, some auto parts store, and then you can make these push to connect again. That's more of a positive seal. You put some dielectric grease on this, and away you go. But if you got what I got, like, you know, one marker's out. And you can't trace it, you know, the mouse chewed it all up. F it. Just rip everything out and do it again. Isolate the harness, and then you'll be good to go.